Good morning, everybody.
And welcome
to the
joint worship service
at the Escanaba Marketplace.
Woo!
On this rainy day when we gather, remembering our baptism so aptly, it is a joy to worship with both Bethany Lutheran Church and Emmanuel Lutheran Church and our new friends from Fortune Lake Lutheran Camp in Crystal Falls, Michigan. I'm Pastor Lily Brondegg. I'm the pastor at Bethany Lutheran Church.
And I'm Pastor Mike Markwell. I'm the pastor at Emmanuel. And we're excited to be here with all of you.
Both of our congregations are in the midst of hearing gospel texts about Jesus as the bread of life. As we get ready for the work of Vacation Bible School through our evening camp this week, we lean into the promise that through Jesus there is always enough. And what better way to celebrate that than through this joint ministry together? I invite you all to take a deep breath in and then let it out as we prepare ourselves for worship today. We will begin with a fun gathering song led by our new friends from Fortune Lake, and we're going to have them come up here now and introduce themselves and lead us in our opening song.
Hello, my name is Aster.
Hi,
and I'm a cabin leader at Fortune Lake, but right now I'm helping with day camp, or is it evening camp? Okay, and then my favorite flavor of ice cream is probably just vanilla. It's kind of bland, but I like it.
Hi everybody, my name is Mia.
Hi Mia.
Back at Fortune Lake, I'm normally a cabin leader, but now I'm here. And my favorite ice cream flavor is Superman.
Yeah. Hi everybody, I'm Ashton.
Hi Ashton.
I'm also a cabin leader at Fortune Lake, but I happen to be here this week. And then my favorite ice cream flavor, I'd have to say cookie.
So with that, we would like to give you a little introduction in how our day camp is going to work. So we're doing a 3-day long of evening day camp. I know it sounds simple, but it's not. It's super fun and it's super exciting because we get to talk about a theme of like every year. Every year we create a theme, and this year it's created to be dot, dot, dot. I know, you're wondering what that dot 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 is. And each day is different. We have created to be free, created to be authentic, and created to be brave / disciples. So every day that we spend talking about all of these things, the kids learn about reading, specifically reading. So being authentic is this reading about Mary and Martha. Being free is about, what is it being free about? Yes, so it's like when this reading, thank you, about when God tells us that he takes They take our burdens away with grace and let us go and be free after being forgiven. Then we have the authentic one, that it's Mary and Martha's story of when Jesus goes and visits them. And Martha is like cleaning all around and Mary's like listening. But Jesus says like, yes, you need to listen to me and you need to listen to God and breathe and be happy. And then we have being brave. That's my favorite. That's the Goliath and David story. And we do like, the amazing thing about our readings is that we do like this reader's theater thing with the kids. And so they get really into it and they love it. So that's one of the examples of the things we do in between camp songs and camp songs and camp songs and again and again and again. And fun games and fun arts and crafts and a lot of things that bring a little bit of flavor of camp to your kids. So we're very thankful that you're all here. We are very thankful that we have more than 35 kids now and signed in. So we're gonna have a lot of fun. And thank you to our volunteers. We know that we also have a lot of volunteers and we love you guys to get involved in, well, all of this big, big, big show, because we love it. Now we're gonna do a song. I know, I talked a lot, I'm so sorry. I just go with it. So our song is called Humble Thyself. So I'm gonna teach it. Repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
Humble thyself in the sight of the Lord.
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 Why? Because our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God.
Who reigns?
Who reigns?
From heaven above.
From heaven above.
With wisdom, power, and love.
With wisdom, power, and love.
We're gonna change the humble thyself to serve or love in different words, and then at the end we're gonna go back to humble thyself. Are we ready to put that together?
Yeah.
Yes, awesome.
Thank you.
invite you to rise as we continue worship with words of confession and hearing God's promise of forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
I invite you to join me in the Kyrie led by the Fex.
So we have strong worship and praise. Let us break.
the day together. You can find the words to this prayer on your insert titled Today's Readings at the very top. Let us pray. O God, eternal goodness, immeasurable love, you place your gifts before us. We eat and are satisfied. Fill us and this world and all its needs with the life that comes only from you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
A reading from Exodus. The whole congregation of the Israelites complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh foot and ate our fill of bread, for you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I'm going to rain bread from heaven for you. And each day the people shall go out and gather enough for that day. In that way, I will test them whether they will follow my instructions or not." Then Moses says to Aaron, "Say to the whole congregation of the Israelites, draw nearer to the Lord, for he has heard your complaining." And as Aaron spoke the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the complaining of the Israelites. Say to them, at twilight you shall meet, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord of your God." In the evening, quails came up and covered the camp. And in the morning, there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there on the surface of the wilderness was a fine flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to another, "What is it?" For they didn't know what it was. Moses says to them, "It is bread that the Lord has given to it." The word of the Lord. Thanks be God.
We will sing our psalm together today responsively. And what that means is I will sing a line, and then you will sing in the same tone the line in bold. Our psalm for today comes from Psalm 78.
Thank you.
A reading from Ephesians. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore, it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. What does it mean but that he had also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who ascended far above all heavens, so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of the ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming, but speaking the truth in love. We must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, for whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand as you are able for the gospel acclamation. According to John. Glory to you, O Lord. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were beside the sea, they themselves got into boats and went to Capernaum, looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you come here? Jesus answered them, Very truly I tell you, you are not looking for me because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal. Then they said to him, What must we do to perform the works of God? Jesus answered them, This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So they said to him, What signs are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What works are you performing? Our ancestors ate manna in the wilderness, as it is written, He will give them bread from heaven to eat. Jesus said to them, Very truly, I tell you, It is not Moses who gave you bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven, the bread of God that is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. They said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. And Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated, and I invite our children to come forward. We'll just kind of stand here. It's kind of dirty on the floor, so we won't sit. But I have a picture here, and can everyone tell what this is in the congregation? It's Jesus! Oh, but maybe you girls can look closely for me. What do you see when you look real close? Yeah, what do you see? Yeah, there are individual pictures of people that make up this bigger picture of Jesus. So sometimes when we look at something really close, we see that other things are there that we miss when we look at it from far away. In today's gospel, we hear of the followers of Christ, the crowd, who was going to look for Jesus, but they were looking really close for something. And what they missed was that God is all around us, always doing amazing works. We don't have to look real hard to see God or see Jesus. All we have to do is open our eyes and see the amazing things that he's doing around us. Thank you for coming up. You can go have a seat. Let us pray. God, we give you thanks that you are in our midst, that we can open our eyes to see the amazing work that you are doing in and around and through us constantly. We give thanks for this wonderful opportunity to gather together in worship and celebration of our joint ministries this week, providing this summer camp for youth in Escanaba. We pray that you allow us to open our eyes to see the ways that you are already at work through this ministry. That it's not what we do, but what you are doing. We pray this in your name. Amen. When I was a child, we played a lot with the neighbors in our block, and we would play hide and seek, which means we had about 10 to 15 backyards to hide in. And that was a whole lot of fun. And so these games of hide and seek could become very elaborate and could take most of the day when you have all those places, all those trees and bushes and hiding under decks. It could take a long time to be found. I am not good at hide and seek. See, if I am the hider, I'll find a great spot, and especially as a kid, I'd hide there for about 5 minutes, and I'd get bored and want to be with all of my friends. So I would let myself be found so I could be around other people. Now my brother, on the other hand, who is a lot more naturally introverted than me, he would bring a book with him when he was hiding. And he would spend hours hidden away just waiting for us to find him. The good news in today's gospel is that we do not have to look very hard or far to find where God is in our community. All we have to do is open our eyes, because God is constantly at work around us. In today's gospel, we'll start with the Old Testament. In the Old Testament reading, we have the Israelites who have been led out of slavery in Egypt into the wilderness. And they're starting to get to their complaining phase, where they are complaining to Moses and Aaron, "Why have you taken us out of Egypt? We might have been slaves there, but at least we had enough food to eat. Surely we will die here." And God heard these complaints. And although God had already shown up, had already been in their midst, had already led them out of slavery in Egypt and would care for them, God showed up yet again, providing them the manna in the wilderness. And I think preemptively in this reading, knowing that they were going to complain, that they would just get bread, also gave them the quail. God shows up time and time again. And then in the gospel reading today, we have the story of how Jesus had gone with his disciples, the 12, to the other side of the sea. And there the crowds found him. And I find this first question the crowds ask a little amusing. Jesus, when did you get here? See, they're asking this in a very concrete form of, you know, when did you arrive? When did you arrive to the marketplace here today? Would be the equivalent. But as we look back at it with our 21st century Christian eyes, there's a little humor in the idea of when did Jesus show up? Well, Jesus has always been here. And then Jesus's response to the disciples, or to the crowd that was gathered, was, "Why are you looking for me? Are you looking for me because you have seen the signs and miracles that point towards me being the Messiah? Or are you here to get more bread? Are you here to receive the benefits of that?" I still remember the first time I heard the Janis Joplin song, Mercedes-Benz. "Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz? My friends all drive Porsches, I must make amends. I work hard all my lifetime, no help from my friends. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz?" Now, aren't you glad I'm a pastor and not a musician? But I remember hearing that song when I was in middle school or high school and just thinking that I think that Janis Joplin was onto something with the humor of it a little bit. What do we ask God for? Are we asking for a Mercedes-Benz, something, you know, lavish and over the top? The other verses are color TV, which I've never known a black and white TV. So that doesn't resonate with me quite as much. But there's this idea here that the disciples are asking, or perhaps they're in this, or not the disciples, the crowd are in this for that Mercedes-Benz, for what God can provide. And rather, the question is, what are we drawn to the gospel for? Is it the promise of bread, of a great potluck afterwards? Is it the promise of being able to worship in beautiful buildings surrounded by our friends? All of these things are good things, but the promise of the gospel is that Christ is the Messiah. That these signs are not just for our own benefit, but for all the world. And there's a little part of this that when we get to the point where we acknowledge that it's not about us and what we receive, there's a beauty in that. This week, as we're preparing for our joint camp experience, this is now the second year in a row that we've done it, and last year was amazing, and I know that this year is going to be too. See, it's a partnership between Emmanuel and Bethany, but really between Emmanuel, Bethany, Fortune Lake, and the entirety of Escanaba. And one of the beautiful things that happens when we enter into this partnership to put on something like this is we do it, first of all, because we can do more together than we can separately on our own in regards to this. We can achieve more for the sake of God together than we can in our individual congregations. And the second thing that I think is beautiful that comes out of this is that it is not about the individual glory of ourselves or our individual congregations. Rather, we are coming together purely to see the amazing things that God is going to do. And God has already been at work through this opportunity. God is already at work through the volunteers who have committed time and hours into decorating and setting up the tent for some outdoor space and all the pre-registration stuff that goes into this, the planning. God is already at work through those who have helped to make this worship service, this celebration possible through our musicians, through our tech people, through all of you who have brought a dish to share for our potluck. God is already at work in these ways. And God's already at work in the campers who will be coming to join us this week. And God's at work through our counselors from Fortune Lake who are at the end of a long summer of teaching youth and the transformative summer, and they've got one more good week in them, and we're glad to have them here. And God's at work through the campers who are going to show up, whether they have heard the gospel 1,000 times or if they're hearing it for the first time, whether they feel that they have a community of faith that accepts them and welcomes them, or if that's something that they're looking for in their life. God is already at work in we just need to open our eyes to see where God is. God is not hiding from us. We don't have to go looking behind bushes or under patios and decks, hidden away in backyards. Rather, we can rejoice and celebrate that God is in our midst and that we are partnering in this together. Amen.
Everybody, we're going to sing another song. It's called Fill My Cup. So if you could repeat after me, I'll teach it to you. All right, so it goes, fill my cup and let it overflow.
Fill my cup and let it overflow.
Fill my cup and let it overflow. Oh, yeah.
Fill my cup and let it overflow. Yeah.
Fill my cup and let it overflow. Let it overflow with love. And then we're going to do it that same, like, tune, and we're going to do it to Jesus Loves Me. Yeah.
Fill my cup and let it overflow.
With the whole church on earth, let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Calling on the Spirit of wisdom to guide our hearts and minds, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. O wise one, your wisdom has been present in this world since its beginning. Pour out your wisdom into the hearts of the whole church, especially the newly baptized, lay leaders, deacons, pastors, and bishops. Merciful God,
receive our prayer. Holy God of all creation, you are the source of all life. Where the sun blazes hot and strong, bring a gentle breeze. In the places experiencing the cold of winter, bring your warmth. Merciful God, receive our prayer.
Compassionate God, help government leaders of this entire world unite for peace and justice. Humble all who hold authority, that power is directed toward a more just society. Merciful God.
Bread of life from heaven, you feed us. Fill all who are hunger with needed nutrition and open our hearts to eliminate hunger in this world. May we see a day when all are fed. Merciful God. Receive our prayer.
O wisdom of truth, help us to understand your will for the church. Be with congregations experiencing transition, redevelopment, and the exciting yet frightening path of newness. May your wisdom be found at every step. Merciful God.
Receive our prayer. God of all imagination, be with us, the people of Bethany, Emmanuel, and Fortune Lake, as we go about the work of this Escanaba evening camp. Be with us in the games, crafts, music, and meals. Grant us patience and creativity as we seek to build relationships, shape lives, and be your witnesses through our camp this week. Be with all the campers, opening minds and hearts. Merciful God, receive our prayer.
Redeeming God, we give you thanks for the lives and witness of your saints now departed. Especially, we remember today, Reverend Dean Peterson. Bring your beloved into eternal glory, opening wide the gates to the heavenly banquet. Merciful God,
receive our prayers.
We lift up these prayers to you, gracious God. Receive them into your holy keeping. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share signs of that peace with one another.
Thank you.
Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the life of the world. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered together by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Here at this table, we are practicing an open table. Wherever you may be on your spiritual journey, you are most welcome to receive these gifts of bread and wine, God's grace made real for you. Our ushers will come down the center line and dismiss you row by row, and there will be two communion stations on either side. You can come through the communion line and then return to your seat. There is gluten-free wafers available. Please just ask for that in your line. If you are not able to come forward, let the ushers know, and at the end of the communion line, we will bring communion to you. There is a non-alcoholic grape juice option in the center of these trays. Christ has set this table with more than enough for all. Come and see. There are trash cans behind the first pillar on either side for your empty communion cup. the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray. Amen.
We have a few announcements before we conclude our worship today. First of all, thank you to everyone who helped to make this joint worship possible. Thank you to Pastor Lily and to our wonderful musicians, John and Kim Beck. And thank you to the Fortune Lake counselors as well. Thank you to Kyra for running tech and for Craig Warple, who has helped set up the space and is running around and moving microphones. We thank you, all these people and the people I haven't named who have helped make this possible. Thank you so much. We can applaud. A few other announcements. So first of all, in case you didn't know, we have a summer camp going on this week. Starting tomorrow night will be the first night of the program. And we invite, if you haven't signed up already, we can still take some registrations. 4 o'clock will be when that starts. We will be serving the kids a meal, so thank you to our volunteers who have signed up to serve those meals. If you are volunteering at camp this week, after our potluck today, we'll invite you to go back to Emmanuel, which is already set up in camp mode over there. We'll have a volunteer meeting that will give you a chance to become familiar with the space if you aren't already so, and we'll let you know what we're doing and what we're expecting of you if you already don't know that. So join us back at Emmanuel around 1 o'clock when the potluck finishes up for that volunteer meeting. Other announcements, Thursday night. So our camp counselors from Fortune Lake will only be with us Monday through Wednesday, but we're going till Thursday. And Thursday night, we have a community night. We're inviting you all to come and see what amazing things our youth have been working on all week. If the weather permits, we'll be outside for a little bit of a bonfire. It'll be a great time. And that will be at Emmanuel. At 5 o'clock, we'll be serving a hot dog dinner to the community as well. So show up for some hot dogs and some time to really see what amazing things the youth have been doing this coming week. Another thing I want to lift up is our UP State Fair Water Tent is a joint ministry of all the churches in the conference. And so Emmanuel's day is Wednesday. We have all of our volunteers signed up. Bethany's day is Thursday. If you have any more questions about that, if you have any more questions about that, you can speak to the respective pastors about that. If you are at the fair, stop by our tent. Proceeds from that go towards clean water projects. It's an amazing ministry that we're able to do, and it's the cheapest water in the state fair. So come by and say hello if you're at the fair. Those are all of the announcements I have.
That was all. It is all hands on deck for this joint ministry. I just wanted to share a little impact story before an ask. But an impact story. Last year at the end of this week that we did together, this vacation Bible school for the community, that we do with an intentional edge of community outreach, during our closing ice cream social, one of the campers' grandmas came up to me, made a gift to make sure that this program continues year to year, and said, thank you. Before this week started, my grandson did not have language to talk about a God who loved them and didn't know who Jesus is. And now he does. And this is the kind of impact that we can have together and why this ministry that we do together is so vital for our community. This week we have 43 campers registered and 20 volunteers signed up to help. This is an incredible number. We can applaud ourselves. But this work, not only is it fun, but it matters and it changes lives. So, if you would like to help serve and clean up after meals, we are in need of a little help in that area. On each night, if you are willing to serve. You can talk to Pastor Mike or you can just show up at like 3:45 and be like, I would like to help with meals, and we will give you something to do. So that's my final ask. This ministry is great. And if you are someone who has signed up to volunteer or signed up to be a camper this week, I would like you to come on forward right now. We're gonna bless you. Come on forward. Everyone who has signed up to be a camper and to volunteer. And volunteering also looks like hosting our counselors for the week. So if you are a person who has signed up to host our counselors for the week, we would like to bless you also. Also, counselors, you're going to camp. Look at this beautiful gathering of God's people. Now, at Bethany, sometimes I ask people to get their blessing fingers out. And so you can just lift a hand towards these folks to help us bless them. Or if you're feeling jazzy, this is what a blessing finger is. It's a nice jazz hand that we extend to those who we are blessing. So let us bless these beautiful people. And this is a blessing from Pastor Meta Herrick Carlson for going to camp together. These are the days for outdoor voices, for long sprints and splashes that sweat and cool like freedom. These are the nights for wild noises and the crackle of bright campfires, eyes that find heaven's starry banner above. These are the foods, songs, and spaces that help stick faith to our bones, that locate God's love so near after all. These are good ways to practice rejoicing, to notice Christ in mud on our feet and on the face of friends with fat flashlights and the steady buzz of a bug in our ears. This life is a gift. This faith is an adventure. Blessed are you who explore it all with awe. Thank you all. You can head back to your seats. Shortly, we will be beginning our time of potlucking together, one of the most holy ministries of the church, if you ask me. We have some friends setting up the food back there. If you could please, there are empty tables back there. If you could please grab a chair or find a friend who can grab your chair from our worship space and bring it back there. And we'll say a word of table grace. No, we won't. Sorry. After our sending song, our summer staff from Fortune Lake will lead us in a camp table grace, because that's going to be way more fun.
The blessing of God, which provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us, be upon you now and forever. Amen. I invite our camp counselors up to lead us in our last song.
Hi, everybody. I'm still Ashton. And I'm going to teach you guys IMSC song / chant, whatever you want to call it. So repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
I am a C.
I am a C.
I am a CH.
I am a CH.
I am a CHRISTIANNNNN.
I am a CHRISTIANNNNN.
And I have CHRIST.
In my
H-E-A-R-T.
In my H-E-A-R-T.
And I will L-I-B-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y.
And I will L-I-B-E-E-T-E-R-N-A-L-L-Y.
So what I'm spelling is, I am a Christian, I have Christ in my heart, and I will live eternally. We will sing that probably 3 or 4 times, and we'll try and get a little faster every time.
I am a Christian. I am a CH. I am a CHRISTIANNNNNN. I am CHRIST in my H-E-A-R-T.
give you in a table, Grace, before we eat?
We will do
the brown cow. So repeat after us.
We thank the brown cow for the chocolate milk.
We thank the brown cow for the chocolate milk.
We thank the pig
for the bacon on the grill.
We thank the pig for the bacon on the grill.
We thank the chicken for the egg and the egg for the chicken.
Thank you.